In this video, I'm going to show you how to recreate a skeleton loader in WeWeb using CSS animations. So if you look at the editor here, we can see that our skeleton is composed of two divs. The main wrapper, which has a gray background, and a gradient that is moving from left to right. So let's build that from scratch. And I'm going to hide this. And we are going to add a new div that will be our skeleton. And let's add fixed width and fixed height. We're going to add a background color and a border radius. Inside of our div, we want our gradient, so we are going to add a div. Let's call that gradient. It was shimmer here, but let's call that gradient. And for the gradient value, we are going to add this value here, which is basically a linear gradient definition. And let's set that here on our new gradient here. And now we want that gradient to fill the container, the skeleton. So we are going to give it 100 width and 100 height. So now we see that we have a nice gradient filling the square. And in the editor, we're seeing this dashed line, which I'm not a big fan of. So I'm just going to quickly add a hidden div inside of it, so we can get rid of this dashed line in the editor. So now we have the basis of our skeleton. Now we just need to animate it. In an HTML embedded, I've added our keyframe animation here, which has a translate x minus 100% to 100%. This means that any element that has this animation, we go from left to right. And now we just need to add the animation to our gradient in the custom CSS. So the animation property takes the name of the animation, the duration, the easing, and if it loops or not. Now that it's done, we have our skeleton, and let's try and change the height of the skeleton. We can see that since our gradient fills the container, it adapts automatically and still works when we narrow the height of the components. So we can have one like this. If I duplicate it, I can also have it like so. Let's wrap it up. And we get our nice shapes here.